Hello everyone and welcome aboard this morning flight to a country that could be described as a very young but with a painful trajectory to freedom. Independent since 1990, it is the third youngest country in Africa after the independence of Eritrea in 1993 and South Sudan in 2011. Formerly an unnamed land, then baptized Southwest German Africa, when the German colonization started in 1884, this country inherited its current name from a name of a desert, the Namib Desert, which, by its inhospitality, kept at bay the first explorers. Welcome to Namibia.
African History Daily by my daddy.
After brief Portuguese incursion in the 15th century and Dutch exploration in the 18th century, the Germans eventually colonized the land. They occupied the west coast in 1878 and undertook evangelizing missions. In 1884, the region officially became a German protectorate called Southwest German Africa. Farmers and merchants started to settle, but not without a fierce resistance, including that of the Herero people entrenched in land. It is in response to the resistance that the German government caused one of the biggest trauma in the history of Namibia. January 10, 1904 marks the beginning of the Herero uprising led by Chief Samuel Maharero. Witboy, leader of the Nama people, joined insurgents who harassed German farmers and destroyed infrastructure. Lieutenant General Lothar von Trotter, appointed commander-in-chief of the German colony troops with a mission to end the Herero revolt. He won a decisive victory at the Battle of Waterberg, August 11, 1904, which resulted in the massive killing of Hereros, not only warriors, but also women and children. Von Trotter's action repelled German public opinion and he was finally dismissed from his command. But Herero survivors and their Nama allies are kept in concentration camps or served as cheap labor. Many died from malnutrition or illnesses. This genocide that lasted from 1890 to 1908 killed nearly 60,000 people, with 75% of the Herero population having been decimated. After the Treaty of Versailles and the German capitulation in the First World War, the Germanic power is forced to abandon its colonies. The League of Nations then placed the Namibian territory under the mandate of the Union of South Africa, which actually continued the expropriation of black farmers for the benefit of the Boer, the Dutch white farmers who obtained the majority of the land. In 1928, segregation was even introduced as in South Africa. Nevertheless, despite several attempts by Pretoria to annex it, Namibia remains separated from South Africa. In 1958, the Ovambo even demanded independence and together with the other indigenous people created the Southwest African People Organization, originally a union, the SWAPO. In the context of post-war decolonization, the United Nations revoked this mandate and placed Southwest Africa under the supervision of the United Nations. Then came 1967 and the beginning of the SWAPO guerrillas against the South African presence. 1 year later, Southwest Africa was renamed Namibia by the UN, which was followed 3 years later by the recognition of the International Court of Justice of the illegality of South African presence in Namibia. This independentist and socialist organization enjoyed the support of Angola and Cuba. The SWAPO is recognized by the United Nations General Assembly in 1973 as the sole representative of the Namibian people. In 1978, the UN Security Council adopted Resolution 435, which provides the beginning of Namibia's independence process. In the conflictual atmosphere prevailing during the 1978 to 1988 decade, this resolution is initially poorly respected. It is finally implemented in the wake of the agreement concluded between South Africa, Angola and Cuba in December 1988. This resolution will lead to the holding of elections in November 1989, won by SWAPO, and then the adoption of a constitution on 9 of February 1990. The last colony of Africa is from today released. The destiny of the country is now in our hands, then declared President Samuel Nujoma in this March 21st, 1990, in a stadium full as an egg of the capital Windhoek, this Germanized Dutch name, which is said to mean corner of the wind. My African cliché of the day is a mark of admiration for the people of Namibia, this beautiful country which suffered from a genocide but which enjoys today a good political and economic stability. My admiration for being the first country in the world to put environment protection in its constitution and to involve local tribes and population through a system that fairly distributes the economic returns of the tourism business. Dear friend, that is it for today, and I let you reflect on your own cliché on this little known part of the African continent. And I look forward to seeing you tomorrow for our last flight of the week, which also will close the ongoing series on the history of the Mali Empire in medieval Africa. Thank you.